Greetings, Benjamin J. the Victrolaguy, with another in the series on the Edison 1878 tinfoil phonograph. Well, I went down to Menards, and I picked up a roll of aluminum duct tape. The stuff made specifically for taping ductwork. And it's adhesive aluminum, and it's about 2/1000ths of an inch thick. So, it was 12 bucks, but a big old monster roll of the stuff. So, I figured, what the heck? Let's buy a roll and see what happens. Now, I've already done one recording on this, and it's surprising. This stuff is really, really thick, but it makes a decent recording. So I'm just going to do a video to document it. And as you see, it's just aluminum foil with adhesive on one side. Like I said, this is made for actual duct work, heating ducts. So, let's see if we can get this thing on here reasonably straight. And hopefully, reasonably wrinkle-free. Now I'm off about one groove, it looks like, on the mandrel. But for this test, that's more than good enough. And the nice thing about this stuff is, of course, you can just go down to the store and buy it. But I had never used it before, and I thought I would give it a shot with surprising results. And it's easy, or fairly easy, to get back off the mandrel. So I'll just roll this edge over a little bit. And I haven't readjusted the machine. This is still set up for recording on extra heavy-duty aluminum foil. So, let's see. There's the very first groove right there. Mandrel. Okay, we are now in the foil. So that's our starting point. Second groove on the mandrel. So this is a bit noisier. In fact, it's a lot noisier than the stuff I was using last night. But it makes a really bright, crisp, clear recording. So let's record on this new aluminum duct tape on the 1878 demonstration tinfoil photograph. And getting a message. Hello, hello, hello. Mary had a little lamb. Its fleece was white as snow. And everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go. Ha, ha, ha. All right. So, recording on aluminum tape. And I didn't have to order it and wait 2 weeks for it to get here. I just walked into Menards and they have rolls and rolls and rolls and rolls and rolls of it. Including 3-inch widths, which is a bit wide, but I could always cut it down to fit. Okay, so here's a recording on aluminum foil duct tape. So, it works. So, I'm beginning to think it's the adhesive itself, not so much the foil. And trying to wrap foil around the mandrel, yes, it'll record, but it isn't very efficient, simply because there's too much movement in the foil itself as the stylus is indenting it. With this adhesive on it, this stuff is stuck. And so, you're getting a really, really clean embossing in these grooves. By the stylus, which seems to make a tremendous difference in how this works. Let me play this one more time. Now, again, this is just plain old aluminum foil duct tape. So this could be something that I could use if I'm out of anything else and I want to do a quick recording, or if I'm going to be putting the machine on display or demonstrating it. So now, let's see what it takes to get this back off. So I grab the overlap, pull it up. It's not sticking to itself. and it comes right off the mandrel. So, it's interesting to know, and it's interesting that this adhesive back seems to be the key factor in making a good recording on this phonograph. Not so much the foil you're using. It's sticking it to the mandrel, you know, and the mandrel isn't even sticky, so this isn't super aggressive. And like I said, it's made for taping heating ducts. And it's available, and it's reasonably cheap compared to copper, that's for sure. And so I got this entire roll for $12. Now I spent more than that for 42 inches of copper. So it's going to be a good foil to play with and experiment with. It makes a good recording. Not perfect. A lot of noise, but it makes a good, crisp, bright, really well-defined recording. So I just wanted to document it. Plain old duct tape, and this is made by, it's made in the United States, Intertape Polymer Group, www.itape.com. $12. I'm not sure how many feet of it is, but there's plenty here. Lots and lots of recordings. So, again, I just wanted to document the experiment. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, thevictrolaguy@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.